So good morning, one and all, respected chair, co-chair and panelists. It's my pleasure to be a part of AIOS and present this keynote address in front of the August gathering. The aim of this presentation is to make everybody aware that aphakia due to surgical complication or trauma, we should not be very much worried. Because we have all the options and we can go ahead to put a IOL. I have no financial interest in the presentation. So presence of weak genules, inadequate capsular support, and optical aphakia secondary to surgery or posterior lens dislocation makes conventional placement of posterior chamber intraocular lens in the capsular bag or ciliary sulcus difficult or sometimes impossible. In such cases, it can be surgically managed by either anterior chamber IOL, iris fixated or iris claw lenses or SFIOL. SFIOL is most ideal because it behaves as a PCIOL implanted in sulcus, the position being near the nodal point of the eye. And there are several modifications suggested in different techniques for SFIOL implantation, which include glued IOL, sutureless, flapless IOL, or flap IOLs with flaps. Here I am going to describe a design which where we make flaps and also use vitrectomy. So surgical procedure includes 270 degree peritomy from 4 to 8 o'clock position. Almost all cases I need to do a complete vitrectomy and make two scleral flaps of 2 into 4 millimeter dimensions, 180 degree apart at 3 and 9 o'clock position, and then proceed to make a 6 millimeter sclerocorneal tunnel at 12 o'clock position. The sclerotomy ports are positioned 1.5 millimeter behind the limbus, and the externalization of the haptics are done with a 23 gauge engrasping forceps. And talking of the IOL haptic is facilitated by using a 23 gauge needle, which is bent and create a tunnel for the talking. So here is the example of a surgical procedure. This is a case of dislocated IOL into the vitreous cavity. I'm making flaps here at 3 and 9 o'clock position, with the tunnel blade in both the sides. After making the flaps, the sclerocorneal tunnel is made at 12 o'clock position. This facilitates both removal of the IOL and insertion of a three-piece IOL. Now you can see a foldable IOL is on the retina. It has been taken out with the vitreous forceps with help of two hands, just like handshake technique. I guided the IOL into the anterior chamber and taking care of the iris, you need to remove it. And then try to clear all the vitreous in the iris margin. I proceed forward to make a complete PVD and clear all the vitreous devices, which not only helps to have a proper insertion of IOL, and also prevents RD in future. You can see this is a case where I was trying to put the IOL in sulcus, but it is it's going down. Then I have taken care of the haptic and try to rotate the IOL upside down to make the IOL into proper position. The haptic is out and in proper position now. Other haptic I have wrapped with a engrasping forceps 23 gauge. Now making the scleral tunnel with help of a 26 gauge bent needle and putting the haptic into the tunnel and tucking it. The other side tunnel is being made. You can change your hand to facilitate this tunnel creation. And at the end, we are not putting any sutures on the sclera. Just the conjunctiva is sutured and is looking fine at the end of the surgery. This is another example where a rigid IOL, which has not fully dislocated but subluxated, but had lot of vitreous and capsular bag material and cortical material around it. I always put an infusion cannula, which makes the globe rigid and also facilitate vitrectomy to clear all the vitreous. The same way flaps are made, tunnel made, and now trying to grasp the IOL. As because the IOL is entangled with capsular material and also some vitreous, it was taking little time. Now it has come out. You can see this is a rigid IOL. Again, you have to take care of the iris, and then it is important. You have to pull all the vitreous from the wound to ensure complete vitrectomy in the anterior segment and at the margin of the iris. Again, I am inducing PVD and trying to clear all the vitreous. The IOL is now getting into it. Now the IOL is first haptic is coming out. The trailing haptic you have to put carefully, the trailing haptic behind the iris. Use a light pipe and from the scleral port to help the haptic to take out. The same procedure with bent needle tunnel and trying to put it. So a three-piece standard PCI.
It's my humble request to Dr. Santosh to please sum it up within next 30 yes, seconds.
Yes, last slide. So this is a very nice procedure where very little complications like mild hypotony or vitreous hemorrhage may occur, but you can have a very nice post-op pictures, and this can be taken as a very good technique with available instruments to put a available PC IOL as a scleral fixated IOL. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Santosh.